Oh, in Matthew chapter 8, 1 through 3, a leopard came to him, fell down and worshiped him. Most would have thought that a leopard, the first thing he'd have been doing is saying, heal me, Jesus. Fix it, Jesus. Deliver me, Jesus. But the leopard, his high motive was to worship. Come on, somebody. And in the middle of worshiping, Jesus said, what will you have me to do unto you? And he said, Lord, that you might make me clean. And Jesus said, I will, be thou clean. Matthew 8, 1 through 3. But somebody shout, he came worshiping. The leopard came worshiping. Most folks today, when they come to the altar, if they were a leopard, they'd be screaming out, oh, God, heal me. Oh, Lord, God, heal me. Heal me. Heal me. Whatever the problem would be, that would be their approach to the altar. God, fix it. God, do it. God, mend it. Come on, somebody. God, please answer and get me out of this. But the leopard came and he worshiped. And he said, Lord, if it's your will, I know you can make me whole. And Jesus stretched forth his arm and said, I will, be thou clean. Somebody shout, my wonder from this wonderful Jesus. This wonder working Jesus. Somebody shout, I'll find the wonders in worship. Worship's not praise. When I praise him, I'm praising him for what he's done. I'll praise him for what he's going to do. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. But when I worship him, I have nothing in mind he's done or going to do. All I think about is him. And some folks never worship. They can praise him. Anybody can praise him with fast food. When an up-tempo song that makes you feel a little good and gets a little rhythm of moving. Come on, somebody. Anybody can praise him, but not everybody can worship him. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Come on tonight. Somebody shout, but to worship him is just that. I don't come for any other motive, any other reason. Lord, I just lift you up. I worship you. And I'm telling you, that's where miracles manifest. Lord, we need a worship service again. So many signs out in front of churches advertise worship service 10:30. Worship service 10:15. 10:40. I'm telling you, I get so confused anymore. I don't know when it's going to start. Especially as you travel like I do and go from church to church to different churches. Amen. It's hard to keep up because everybody changing the times anymore. Hallelujah. I don't know no more. Worship service advertised starts at 11. Come on, somebody. And some come in an hour of worship, they call. A Sunday morning they call worship service and never ever really worship. Because people will shout you down if you preach a Jesus that's going to do something for them. They'll scream, dance, and holler. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. But can I tell you, there's a Jesus that's already said in John 19 and 30, it's finished. Somebody shout, it was did on the cross. Whatever you need him to do was did. Somebody said, done, did. Hallelujah. You ain't got to get her done, did. Come on, somebody. The Bible said in Romans 8 and 32, he spared not his own son, but delivered him up for us all. How shall he not with him freely give us all things? Somebody shout, Jesus was God's best. God gave his best on the cross, and if he gave his best, don't you know he's willing to do the rest? Come on, focus on his cross tonight. Focus on his love for you and how he shed his blood for the remission of our sins. Why? Because Hebrews 10, 19 said, wherefore, beloved brethren, having boldness entered into the holiest by the blood of Jesus. Jesus didn't shed his blood just so you could say my sins are forgiven and sit there. Come on, somebody, and stare. He shed his blood so you could come into his presence, into the holiest of his presence. Into that central place of his countenance. Hallelujah! I can't tell you the times throughout close to 25 years of preaching, of watching people say, I know I'm healed, but I don't know when it happened. Or I got the breakthrough, but I just kind of noticed, I didn't realize when it happened. Most all of them, I can always tell them, I said, I know where it happened. When you forgot about what you needed him to do for you, and you just got so attracted to him, and all you could think about was him, and all you could pray for was him. Come on, somebody. My God, how long has it been since you focused your attention in prayer just for him? Come on. I know there's power and virtue that flows from the hem of his garment, but I want you to know the hem of his garment would have had no power without the hem that was in the hem. Come on, somebody. I'm telling you, without his person, there is no power. Without him, there is no wonders. Come on, somebody. Worship him tonight. Come on, just tilt your head back. Lift up your hands without any other motive of raising your hand to get something from him. And just begin to talk to him and worship him and pour out your heart to him and say, Lord, I want you. Jesus, you're my greatest need. Lord, I need you. Come on, tell him something kind of like this. Jesus, you're my greatest need. Yes, Lord, you're my greatest need. Come on, tell him, hallelujah. Jesus, you're my greatest need. Jesus, you're my greatest need. I need you, Lord. You're the need that I have that's above any need, Lord. Oh, I need thee. Oh, I need thee, Lord. How I need thee, Jesus, I need thee. How I need you more, Jesus. How I need thee, Lord. Who did my shandri and lululululub on Sunday? Come, Jesus, I wanna see your face. Lord, I want to see your face. Lord, I want to behold your face. Lord, I want to be that close. Come on, kiss the Son, lest he be angry. Psalms 112. Come on and kiss. Come on and kiss the Son of God. The word kiss means to worship. Worship him. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Psalms 45 and 11, the Bible said, so shall the king desire your beauty. Worship thou him, Holy Ghost, Lord. We worship you, Jesus, wonderful God. Holy, holy, come on, worship at his footstool. Hallelujah, he is worthy. Hallelujah, exalt ye the Lord our God, worship at his footstool. Come on, exalt ye the Lord our God, worship at his footstool. Come on, exalt ye the Lord our God, worship at his footstool. He is holy. He is holy. Psalms 99 and 5. Hallelujah, Lord, you're holy, and we worship you in the beauty of holiness. Hallelujah, Lord, because when we worship, Lord, we must relinquish every part of us. Lord, to worship you is to surrender my life, place it in your eternal hands, Lord. Hallelujah, we worship. Come on, tell him some lie. Lord, here am I, send me, Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord, here am I, send me, Jesus. Lord, I make myself available to you. Lord, I want to be used by you. Here am I, send me, Jesus. Lord, I don't hold nothing back. I worship you with all of my heart. Oh, don't hold back anything from me no more, Lord. Holy, holy, little Moshe, take me on, Lord. I give it away. I give myself up to you tonight. Whoa, because this is worship. Lamentation 3:51 said, I will lift up my hands with my heart unto God who dwells in the heavens. I lift up my hands with my heart unto God who dwells in the heavens. I'm not just lifting my hand, but I lift up my hands with my heart unto God who dwells in the heavens. Lord, I surrender all. Come on, it ain't just lifting a hand, it's lifting your heart. Lift my heart. Lord, I lift my heart. Jesus, I lift my heart. Take it all, Lord, take it all. Lord, I lift my heart, I give it all. Jesus, take my heart. Hear about sin me, Lord Jesus. Here am I, use me, Jesus. Lord, I'm yours every part. I love you, Lord. See, in praise, you can praise him for what he's done or what you're believing him to do, but when you worship, it's not about getting something from him, it's about him getting something from you. Take me, Lord. Here am I. I'm available to you, Lord. At your divine disposal, Lord, use me. Take me tonight. In the spirit, Lord, that's where we long to be. Hearing your voice in a place of intimacy, yeah. The Spirit got on these last days, Jesus, that's where we must be. Oh, Lord, intimately. Come on, lift your hands and say, Lord, take me into the Holy Ghost. Take me into the presence.